All right. Good morning, everybody. I am going live for Second Sunday, which I do every month, and it is an energy report. It is an update as far as where we are in our own personal evolution and where we are in a collective evolution. My name is Jessica Alstrom, and I am an intuitive life coach. I have founded and created a company called Transcendence International Consciousness Academy, which is kind of like a 5D university. And I also have created some global tours where we can go and access consciousness, and we can also pull from the possibilities of the quantum field very quickly in a 3-day worldwide tour. And today I am coming to you from my home office to give you a very special energy update. And instead of doing an energy report for July, I decided that I would give you guys a 6-month kind of projection as far as what to look for and what to look at right now. I know that there's a ton of energy updates right now with really good information. So if you need to know what is going on like today, you can jump on YouTube and there's some amazing teachers. But I wanted to give you, we're at the halfway point of this year. So what I wanted to do is kind of have you pull back a little bit from your now moment of what's going on right now, because what I'm getting collectively from my students is it's so hard and my head hurts and I'm tired and why is my past coming up and why am I angry at drivers and why am I angry for silly things and how come things are not working yet? And this is what I get a lot of from down in the pipeline. So instead of telling you it's all good, you know, we've got the eclipse and we've got the retrogrades and we've got all this and it's just keep moving forward. Let's pull back. Let's pull back and let's pull out. So if we're really going to go within, which is what we're being requested to do spiritually right now, is to go to the deepest parts of ourselves. The best way to be able to see that is for a mirror. And if you guys follow me, you know that I teach all about mirrored consciousness, law of reflection, law of projection, law of attraction, and how all of those laws work together to create your virtual reality that you're sitting in, living in, and thinking that is very real, which it's technically not. It's a hologram of what you see. Now, based in what you see is what you know, is what you feel, is what you believe. But what do you actually see? Do you realize that you're seeing through wounded eyes? Do you realize that you're hearing from wounded ears? And when I say wounded, I mean disassociated from the true higher self that you came here to be. And, you know, life did this to us, for us, through us. And it gave us this gift of kind of pulling us out of our knowing into the unknown and into the uncertainty, where we have to claw our way out of the dirt and find the light, which we realize has always been us. And hopefully you guys got a chance to watch my free webinar, because free money webinar, which is basically become a wealthy light worker, which you actually already are, because all the assets that you'll ever need, the PhD that you're requiring for whatever it is you're doing, is always been within you. But in order for you to be able to truly see what is inside of you, you have to be able to use mirrored consciousness to your advantage. Now, what is 2020? Everybody's talking about 2020, 2020, 2020. Well, think about it. Think about the metaphor behind that idea. 2020 is perfect vision. So what if this whole ascension process is setting us up to experience our perfect vision? Lots of people are telling me that their third eye is itching, that they're getting this headache right here, that they're starting to see things differently, they're starting to feel things differently. And that is basically you right on time for you. Right on time for knowing what is coming for you. And what you see and what you feel is what you know. And therefore, what are you seeing around you right now? How would this perfect vision of 2020 be anything other than completely triggering the crap out of you right now? Why would that all make sense? Well, for us to really see who we are, we have to get space from it. And the way that we get space from what's actually going on in our belief systems is we project it into other forms of consciousness. And we do that by having this beautiful mirror show up for us. And the mirror is other people, places, and things that are either inspiring us or triggering some sort of negative emotion within us. And from those two perspectives, we can see if we have limiting belief systems or if we're right on track with what higher self, which is the true essence of you, is in alignment with. And when we're in alignment, we feel good, we're focused, we're confident, we're excited, we're compassionate, we are not doubtful, we're not worried, we're understanding, But when we drop out of our true perfect vision of what we truly are, and we fall back into the eyesight of the trauma, the eyesight of the wounding, the eyesight of the past, the eyesight of other people's judgments of us, then we begin to drop down in these lower frequencies where we cannot, from that perspective, find a solution. It's like looking for something you've lost in the dark. You can't find it. You need a flashlight, which you have within you. It's your guidance. It's your intuition. It's your soul team. It's your soul family. It's your personal human tribe that's in alignment with your belief systems. You already have this established. If you can hear this message, this quantum message, you've already created some sort of flashlight in the dark process for yourself so that when you're going looking for who and what you are, you can see the essence of that through people, places, and things that also inspire you. For a long time, we've lived in judgment and comparison, but what we're realizing is that in the field of possibilities, there's only two perspectives. There's only two perspectives ever. And those two perspectives create duality. There is limitations and there's possibilities. And if we're getting ready by getting triggered, by knowing ourselves more, because a lot of us don't know what we want, but we do know what we don't want. So usually from that, we can create a catalyst point of what we do want. Because for so long, we've been taught away from what we wanted. And we've been taught to do what's right, what's in according to our family, religion, school, or society. And as we go full circle from that program, we start to settle in ourselves and we ask ourselves, what do I want to see? What do I want to know? What do I want to feel? I know what I feel. I know what I see. I know what I think I want. I know what I don't want. But is that really who I am? So the best way for you to be able to truly, truly see the I am within you is to basically walk around and get triggered both positively and negatively. Because the trigger creates you to settle into your presence. When you stub your toe, you become present. When someone projects a tone on you, you project into the present moment with the past belief system that rendezvous right to the present moment. You bring the trauma from the past into the moment and you say, hey, I don't like your tone. It reminds me of so-and-so, or it reminds me that I'm not good enough, or it reminds me that I'm not value, or it reminds me that I'm not safe, right? So what is it reminding of you? Think about how many planets we actually have in retrograde right now. And retrograde's purpose basically is to push buttons. Push the buttons that are within you. Push the love button, push the money button, push the time button. Oh my gosh, time's speeding up. I wanna have that baby. I wanna find my soulmate. I wanna, you know, finish my website. I wanna contribute to the world before I get too old, right? Or I wanna be, you know, more wise. I wanna know more. I need to know more. You notice that you're always on one perspective of time, relationships, health, and money. You're either in limitation or you're in endless possibilities. But what if we looked at being right in the smack middle of the year as our zero point energy? What if July is actually the zero point where you could discern everything that's going on in your reality right now as either a limitation or a possibility? How could you see right now in your current situation with the triggers that are coming at you, getting smacked in the face constantly, your past showing up, anger issues brewing, right? What would this all mean? Basically, what it is a whisper from deep inside of you that says, these are belief systems, feelings, traumas, and emotions that have not yet been fully and completely processed. And here you go. I'm lovingly going to show it to you in this person, this place, and this thing. Now, what are you going to do with that? What do you choose to see in that? Do you choose to say, thank you for showing me this anger that I have literally avoided and used addiction to hide? Now, if you guys are getting ready to embark in the big I Am workshop that I am putting on at the end of July, it is my final and complete shadow work workshop that I will ever do. And the reason why is because it's complete. The whole idea of where we are right now in this ascension is we are gearing up for the heart opening. And as the heart truly, truly opens, the higher self will become part of this human body. The higher self will begin to see through your eyes and hear through your ears and speak through your lips. No more congestion in your throat chakra, no more pain in your heart, no more bad digestion. This is all contrast. This is all resistance. This is all negative belief systems that have been given and programmed to you, through you, from you, all around your reality. And when the higher self begins to step in and really settle into this human body, your world will change. But you already have a glimpse of that. You already know what that feels like to have higher self present in this body. When you're helping a stranger, when you're paying it forward, when you're helping a client, when you're doing your energy work, when you're reading your cards, when you're in meditation, when you're in dance, when you're in play, when you're in creativity, you already feel the essence of your higher self being in and using this physical body to create what it is that the heart is feeling. But we don't seem to get to feel like that all day, do we? We get to feel that in moments, in glimpses, in hours. And what this part of the ascension is this basically this purge of density within you. There is only one way for you to become conscious of your subconscious, and that is to make the subconscious conscious. And that is what your year has been. It has been everything that has been dormant, disassociated, rejected, avoided, or denied has basically resurfaced. And those moments, those ideas, those suffocated belief systems that we don't want to look at, we don't want to look at our humiliation. We don't want to look at our self-judgment. We don't want to look at our lack programs. So what we do is we stay really, really busy in physical reality trying to create all of those things. I feel lacking, therefore I must produce. I feel devalued, so I must create a version of myself on the outside that looks like someone to be valued, right? I feel unworthy. Okay, therefore I'm working really hard to create worthiness by rescuing and helping and healing everyone around me. Do you see how the deep, deep feeling of how you see yourself creates your physical reality? Now, I know on the surface, we see ourselves as I'm trying, I'm following my dreams, I'm doing everything my mentor says, I'm working really hard, I'm showing up. But what is happening on the inside? Can you dive down and see within? Because if we're on our way to create perfect, perfect vision for ourselves, 2020, perfect vision, that's got to come from your eyes, not your imagination, which means it starts in your imagination and then it trickles down into your human eyes so that you can actually see from the perspective of the physical form that you do create your reality. And you are always creating your reality, but sometimes we're creating a reality that shows us where we're out of alignment. We're showing us where we still don't believe in ourselves, where we still feel limits, where we still feel judgment. And in order for the heart to truly, truly come out of its cage and connect with every other heart chakra on this planet, we're going to have to go deep, deep, deep past anger, and we're going to have to visit our grief. Because I will tell you that it is grief and humiliation that is behind 99% of your wounding. Think about it. How is humiliation? Humiliation creates unworthiness, guys. Humiliation is what has created the devalued point within us. There was something wrong with us. There was something not right. The way we were being was not loved or safe. We had to suffocate our authentic self. And in order for us to keep it stifled and keep avoiding it and keep rejecting it, we had to play that feeling of humiliation over and over and over and over again. And humiliation is one of the greatest childhood wounds that anyone could ever go through. The humiliation of not feeling safe, free, or right to be ourselves. So we go searching for ourselves in other people. We search for the other piece of ourselves in our twin flames. We search for our success in business. We search for love in our children and our pets. But what we're doing is we're returning back to the vision of I am, is I am love. I am peace. I am safe. I am proud. And in order for us to do that, we have to go all the way inside. So we have to go into the shadow space, which is why this last workshop that I'm creating is my final, final shadow work piece. And it is about allowing what is in the way of higher self to move completely into this human body, to be exposed, accepted, shifted, reprogrammed, and loved. That is basically the way that we biohack any kind of biological program, chemical, emotional, or physical, that is running on a cellular subatomic level in our bodies that is producing a version of our reality. Your cells tell your entire system who you are. And from that, from your gut of intuition and through the brain and heart sequences, if there is not complete coherence, the universe is getting mixed signals about who you are. The universe knows who you want to be. That's why it always shows you the car you want. It always shows you the people that you want to be like. It always shows you the money that's possible, the healing that's possible. You're seeing someone else heal from autoimmune disease. You're seeing what's possible outside, but you're not accepting it and holding it and having it yet, because there is a belief system underneath within you that says, I cannot have what I want. I don't get what I want. I'm not valuable enough. I'm not deserving enough. It isn't safe for me to receive, although I want to receive. So if you haven't had an opportunity to watch my free webinar that's on YouTube now or in my community, in Jessica Alstrom Quantum Revolution Community, it's a free webinar. And I really plan to do lots of these free money webinars, because here's the thing, guys. Until we create peace with every out of alignment sequence on this planet, we will always be victimized by it. As long as light workers are afraid or rejecting or out of alignment with how they feel about money, you guys will never have it. And if we never have it, it can't go away, and we can't create new systems, because whatever we resist binds to us like glue. So my fear of money creates my relationship with money, which means I need it, but I don't want it, and I can't have it, but I obviously need it. So in my organization, I make things really simple, although we go deep into the quantum field. I teach that whenever you're out of alignment with something that you want, you'll always need it. Think about that twin flame. You need him to call, stop ghosting you. I need it. I need it. I need it. I need the money. I need the support. I need the investors. I need the help. I need the love. That is as far out of alignment from your higher self that you could ever be. Your higher self sits over here in I have. And the ego personality that's been driving this vehicle and looking through your eyes and hearing from your ears and speaking from your mouth and resisting your desires down here has been the one saying, I need. And then there's the heart center, the inner child, the magic, the alchemist within you. The one within you that can travel from both worlds all the way to the extreme high dimensions of source energy and higher self, all the way down into the shadow realms of the ego personality and the deepest parts of your density, and access your Akashic records and access your frontal lobe and access your imagination and access your heart center and access your intuition. And it has this power to become and show up for you through play. See, that's how the inner child speaks, is through play and through seeing differently, through playing games, through letting go, stop thinking. It was like this morning, it was interesting. I was putting on this necklace, and I put on necklaces all the time without thinking or looking, right? We do that. We put on bracelets, we put on watches, we brush our hair, we do the same things without thinking, without looking. And for some reason, I was struggling this morning to look. I kind of gauge myself, and I found myself looking. I also found myself thinking about how to clasp this, and I couldn't do it. I was overthinking it, and therefore I was breaking my own flow. I know how to do things. We all know how to do things at a subconscious plane. Love, drive a car, write our names, sign checks, right? Turn things on. But then all of a sudden, when we have to think about doing it, all of a sudden you run a blank. So what you're going to notice this year is that your mind is actually, for the first time in your whole spiritual journey, going to get in the way. It's going to get in your way. So my best advice from the zero point of this year, 2019, fresh start of a brand new 7-year cycle, the year of awareness, the year of I am, the year of higher self integrating into the human body and opening up the body's sight and taste and feel and touch from a whole new 5th, 6th, 7th dimensional plane, we have got to go deep, deep, deep within us and find out where our addictions reside, where our avoidances reside, and where our hidden secrets about who we truly think we are buried. And you know what, guys? You don't have to look far. Use your eyes right now. Look around your reality. Look at what do you see? What do you see in other people when you think about how they think about you? What do you see in your life right now as far as the contrast of what you want versus what you have? You know, it's not about having stuff, but that is the ego's marker of completion. It is a completed cycle of action. Therefore, if you want the house or you want the job or you want the relationship or you want the baby or you want the investor, your ego will not sleep until you rendezvous with that manifestation. And if you're not working in creating alignment, all you're doing is chasing a ghost. All you're doing is chasing a shadow. Because there is some place inside of you that you decided very early, maybe not even by your choice, but by your default of observing others and watching other people not be successful, you decided that you too couldn't have what you wanted. So really look at what you see when you look through the eyes of other people at yourself. This is a triple mirrored reflection. It is almost like understanding that 5D is just a house of mirrors. And it's a big, big house with lots and lots of rooms where 3D was just maybe a little tiny home with one mirror. 5D is the great house of mirrors. And so every single toss and turn you make and every hallway you walk down is another reflection of either something that you're avoiding or something that you're celebrating in your life. So it's time to see. It's time to see with your eyes of higher self and decide and choose possibilities over limits. Because if you can choose possibilities over limits right now and as triggered as you are, if you could have the trigger that happened yesterday to you and you could say, let me see, that hurt my feelings, that brought up the feelings of the past, it really triggered some anger, and it makes me feel small and limited. Good. That is one side of your perspective. Now let's shift to the other side of your perspective, your higher self's perspective. I got triggered, which shows me a wound that I haven't thought or felt in a really long time that needed to surface so I could clear and love it from new eyes. This person is showing up perfectly for me to decide whether I want to continue and move forward in my new reality, in my new world with these type of relationships, or do I value myself and have an opportunity and a possibility to shift this relationship right here, right now? Can I also see within me this is a gift? Can I see that this trigger is a gift for me that is making me more aware and present and courageous and speaking my truth and asking for what I need and want? So you can see in every moment, there is a limit and a possibility that awaits in every outcome, in every circumstance. And we use circumstances to basically gauge our reflection, to gauge our consciousness. How conscious am I of who I truly am? Or how conscious am I of who I'm not really? Because the more conscious you are in who you're not, the more your vibration will reflect that. The more your reality will show you through what you see in your physical human eyes, a life that has potential, but not yet realized. Guys, it's that this paradigm is over. Aren't you tired of being potential? Aren't you tired of being triggered by your spouse who has potential, or your friend who has potential, or your client who has potential? Aren't you tired of just seeing potential? Well, the whole paradigm is shifting. And how we actually get to see a new world is a little bit of a contrast. Because it's not just about seeing possibilities and limits. It's about taking action in limits and creating possibilities in those moments. It's about taking divine soul risks within yourself and saying hell yes to your intuition, to yourself. It's about investing in you. It's about creating joy that you want to participate in. You know, the times of having joy through other people's experiences is time's up, guys. I know every empath in the world has had extreme joy by creating someone else's joy. And we have kind of moved around our unworthiness patterns by providing joy and happiness for others, healing for others. But the idea of bringing that back into the base, home base, seems selfish. It seems waste of time. And the only reason why is because your good friend addiction and avoidance says it is. Well, if you're going to do the I Am workshop with me at the end of July, I'm going to tell you that we're going to go deep into the limits and the possibilities of each of your chakra systems. Because at the base of all of your chakras is an initial blueprint of a zero point creative energy of the absolute universe. And on one side, there is a contrast. And on the other side, there is an expansion and a freedom point. There's an abundance point. So if we were going to look at the root, we would see both I am free and I am not free. Ask yourself right now, what is your root? What is your root communicating to the universe? Is your root saying I'm free, or is your root saying I am not? Because those belief systems were created in your first 7 years. And those first 7 years basically dictated a fundamental blueprinting system that you basically auto-generate through your eyes, ears, and vocal cords and feelings that associate who you are with the world. Which means no matter how much you don't want to be like your mother, guaranteed you've been your mother in the last 3 weeks. You've shown up as her. Somehow, some way, you have shown up as her. You have a characteristic trait that gets triggered within you and you act out and channel your mother. No matter how much you don't want to be like her, because it is inside of you. Every character you've ever witnessed has become a piece of your influence. And therefore, when you're not in the present moment, you are basically channeling and acting through other perspectives to survive, to live your life. So as we return to the root and we recalibrate the initial program to I am free, and then we demonstrate that with physical action, because the root is, it resides in density. We must take action in the root. We must act it out. We must feel it and taste it and touch it. It must be real in order for the root to download the new program. And then we move up to the sacral, and the sacral has two contrasting programs at its root initial universal blueprint zero point mark. And one is I am creator. And the other side of that spectrum is I am addicted. Okay. Now I'm not going to get into that because that's obviously the workshop, but you can see that there is two baseline programs that exist in you simultaneously. And you feel the contrast in a 5 minute paradigm, which means in 5 minutes, you can feel absolutely free. And you can also feel absolutely trapped by one conversation, by one thought, by one vision. You can change your perspective like that, which means if you can change your perspective by getting triggered, you can also change your perspective manually. You can override your hormones through intention. You can override the command system of what has been programmed in without your consent in your first 7 years. Regardless if you remember or not what happened in your first 7 years, anything that's showing up right now that does not feel like the truth of who you are is coming from an outdated program. So instead of giving you guys, you know, what does this retrograde actually mean? And what does this eclipse actually mean? Just understand that anytime there is an eclipse that is happening and it is aligned with retrograde energies, it is time to move. It is time to move houses. And think of your, in 2020, have the opportunity to move into your dream house. Think about it. It's something you've built from scratch. You've designed it. You've been waiting a really long time for it to be done. It's done. You're ready to move in. January 2020. Now look at your current situation. Look at your current life. What stays? What goes? You don't want to bring trash into this new dream home. You don't want to have that old outdated furniture and things and you know, stuff, baggage in your closets. It will taint this fresh energy that you're moving into. And this dream house that you have set up allows you to be completely who you came to be. What stays? What goes? Who do you need to be to move into that house? Do you need to be more organized, more disciplined, cleaner? Do you need to be more responsible, which means the ability to respond, to take care of it? Well, this is basically what this part of the ascension is. We're having a major heart opening, and we're also moving into this synchronization of higher self into the human body. We are moving. We are moving into our dream home, which in turn will be your dream body. Because if you think about who you see as your higher self, when you close your eyes and you see your higher self, Does she or he look like the person you see in the mirror? Or is it younger, stronger, better looking, you know, sexier? Like, what do you see when you think about your higher self? Well, that's the house you're moving into. Because we know by now with epigenetics that whatever the central command system of the consciousness dictates the biography of the body, which means your higher self moving into the physical body is going to start talking to your cells differently. It's going to start talking to you differently. It's going to start commanding instead of default programming all of the thoughts of what you're not. You're going to start showing up as you are. And in order for you to do that, you're going to have to choose what you see. You're going to have to choose what you see right now. Right now, in the triggers that are just coming left and right, the opportunities that are have not quite rendezvoused, the money that hasn't yet shown up, how can you choose to see that? You're being tested. Higher self is saying, can you see through my eyes? Can you know through my feelings? Can you hear through my ears? Can you feel from our heart? Or do you still choose to see from the past? Do you still choose to feel from the past? Because that is okay too. That is okay. You're always on time for you, but you have a choice and it's accelerating. This accelerated energy is not going to get easier, which is why next year I'm going to be doing lots of workshops about parallel realities and time and space, because there's versions of you shifting and shifting and shifting and shifting and shifting and shifting and shifting. And there's versions of you that are doing better than you and worse than you right now. And there's versions of you still stuck on timelines from the past that need to be integrated in. And that is going to be a lot of fun for me to be able to teach that next year. But right now, we have got to get the higher self in this physical body so we can start driving this car the way that this multidimensional body was developed. This biocomputer, this quantum biocomputer that is literally a learning computer that is either learning who you choose to be or learning who you always were every single moment, you have the choice. What do you choose to see? So my July 2nd Sunday is about choice and vision and creating that 2020 vision for yourself that you do not allow to be altered, that you hold regardless of what is actually happening around you. See, circumstances don't matter, only state of being matters. We need to see with our third eye and feel with our true hearts, not our broken heart. Most of us are attracted from a broken heart to things and people. But if we were really attracted to this perfect heart that is underneath grief, then everyone would unify. And there would be no ego in the way of perfect relationships and healthy business and prosperous economics and good food. The only thing that is in the way is our programmed pain. Therefore, we keep seeing it everywhere outside of us. So I'm asking you to challenge yourself at this 0 point mark, July, which in our country represents independence. It represents freedom. It represents what we've been fighting for, what we've been working for. This is the month where we celebrate that. And this is a perfect month for you to decide for the next 6 months what you choose to see in people, places, and things, and find celebration and inspiration in the things that resonate with you, and find your traumas and your wounding and the things that trigger you, and change the way you see. All right, guys, that is all I have for this week or this month. And I just wanted to leave you with that important piece that leads us into where we're going for the rest of this year. Here at Tika, we have a very busy, busy rest of our year. I am doing light language activation retreats in Kansas City, where I'm teaching people how to open up their light language, speak their light language, translate their light language, speak other people's light language, use light language hand symbols and codes to activate dormant DNA, teach them a 0 point quantum technique to basically neutralize negative belief systems in our 3 foot fields. And then we also have the QRT tour in Kansas City, where the heart chakra is of the United States. And that is going to be in September 2019. It's going to be a 3 day event. And the idea is come play in the possibilities of the quantum field, which I show you how to move into your Akashic records and move into your third eye and start basically activating the rest of your healing abilities, sequences, light languages, and DNA codes to open up and clear the heart, all through a play-based weekend. So we're going to be playing in the field of quantum physics and playing in the field of possibilities in September right here in Kansas City. And if you guys are ready to go deep diving with me, you can join me in the I Am workshop that starts July 29th. And that is in a private classroom housed on Facebook. If you want to sign up for any of these events, you can go to the quantumrevolutiontour.com website and you can look at the workshops, you can look at the tickets, and you can come join me in this amazing journey of vision. All right, guys, have an amazing July. Use it to your advantage. See what you want to see. Choose what you want to choose and start cleaning house because you are moving to your dream house in 2020. Thanks a lot, guys.